It occurred to me to piece together the odds and ends of you two people, which of course were just as good as ever, and see if I couldn't make a man out of them. If I succeeded, I would have an assistant to help me with my work, and I thought it would be a clever idea to put to some practical use the scraps of Nick Chopper and Captain Fighter. There were two perfectly good heads in my cupboard, and a lot of feet and legs and parts of bodies in the barrel, so I set to work to see what I could do. First I pieced together a body, gluing it with the witch's magic glue, which worked perfectly. That was the hardest part of my job, however, because the bodies didn't match up well and some parts were missing. But by using a piece of Captain Fighter here and a piece of Nick Chopper there, I finally got together a very decent body, with heart and all the trimmings complete. "Whose heart did you use in making the body?" asked the Tin Woodman anxiously. "I can't tell, for the parts had no tags on them, and one heart looks much like another. After the body was completed, I glued two fine legs and feet onto it. One leg was Nick Chopper's and one was Captain Fighter's, and, finding one leg longer than the other, I trimmed it down to make them match. I was much disappointed to find that I had but one arm. There was an extra leg in the barrel, but I could find only one arm. Having glued this onto the body, I was ready for the head, and I had some difficulty in making up my mind which head to use. Finally, I shut my eyes and reached out my hand toward the cupboard shelf, and the first head I touched I glued upon my new man. "It was mine," declared the Tin Soldier gloomily. "No, it was mine," asserted Kuklip, "for I had given you another in exchange for it, the beautiful tin head you now wear." When the glue had dried, my man was quite an interesting fellow.